Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. The type of questions a person asks, that tells what kind of that person is. Like so many people come and ask us questions. Suppose somebody's wife is beating him day and night, what should he do? So I told him, you don't worry. That is between them, husband and wife. Why you worry about it? No, you don't understand. I said, yes, I don't understand. Why you should worry? Maybe that is their wild love. No, Swamiji, I am talking about myself. Questions are never asked in a philosophical manner. Questions must have inquiry, the seed of inquiry. And this is what Bhagavan Rama is asking to Vasishthaji, that Brahman Sasmati Vrud Natayaha Vikitatrute Kim Bijam Kim Tasya Bijam Bijam Tasya Api Kim Bhavet. Three questions. What is the seed of this worldly samsara? What is the seed of that seed? And what is the seed of that seed? So we were told, first of all, Shariram, body identification is the beginning of the world. Then this body identification is influenced by the mind, therefore asha vashanugatam. We are all living our life only what I have to prove, what I have to get. Then this mind or chitta, here also there are two seeds. Dve bije chitta vrukshasya vritti vratati dharana ekam pranaparispando dvitiyam drudavahana. When the bioenergy becomes activated, when we are in deep sleep, that time the bioenergy is at peace. Therefore, the mind is not born. And because the mind is not born, there is no tutu maimai. Upanishad says, in deep sleep, the mother is not a mother, the father is not a father, the husband is not a husband. So there is only life. Mind is not yet born. So when this chetana, then it becomes activated, parisvanda, and then after the body identification, drudha bhavana. We are so convinced that I am body. And as a result of this, yada praspandate pranaha nadi samsparshate vadataha tada samvedanamayam chittam ashu prajayate. So what is the mind? Mind is knowledge where objectivity is predominant. This is one of the biggest problems for every intellectual, educated people. They want to know in objectivity. And this is how the samsara begins. So, sati sarva sama samit prana spandena bodhita samvedyam adaradhyati tato dukkhani chetasaha. So, when this prana spanda, the bioenergy becomes activated, then body identification by the mind, thereafter the objectivity begins, and after the beginning of the objectivity, the samsara full of misery begins. And therefore, yoginaha chitta shantyartham kurvanti prana rodhanam. Therefore, yogis are trying to keep the mind quiet, and therefore they do prana rodhanam. It is the pranayama. There are three types of pranayama. One is called as the puraka pranayama. The second one is Chaka Pranayama. And third one is Bahir Kumbhaka Pranayama. Fourth one is Antar Kumbhaka Pranayama. And ultimate is Kevala Kumbhaka. So this is the stage by stage one has to go. So when we practice this, then slowly, slowly the prana spanda and the breathing also is reduced. Therefore, yogis do this thing. And thereafter, drudhamasana yatakta purva para vicharanam yat ananam padatasya vasanasa pragirna. Without any thinking, when we are accepting the objective world as real, there is no logic behind it. This acceptance of the objective world real is called as vasana or the thoughts. See? So, just observe in your life. Whatever importance we have given to, that alone is the source of misery for us. Give importance to anything. Give importance to cleanliness, you will be miserable. Give importance to the discipline, you will be miserable. Give importance to the punctuality, you will be miserable. See? Give importance to perfection, you will be perfectly miserable. Miserable perfection. So, how the world enters our system? Be attentive. World enters our system by some value that we have given to the worldly things. One boy sees so many girls, no samsara. But to one girl he gives value. I think made for each other. Thereafter mad for each other. Thereafter, mad at each other. Because we have given value. And for this value, there is no logic. Therefore, yakta purva para vicharanam yat adanam padarthasya. And thus, the objectivity is taken as real. And that is what is called as the thoughts or the vasana or impression. Now, bhavitam tivra samvegan atmana yat tadeva saha bhavatya ashusata drupo vasana uvashikrataha. And when we just start getting identified with something again and again, then we mistake it than the reality. I'll tell you one story about this. There was the Hindu-Muslim riots. So one Hindu boy, he wanted to go and kill the Muslims. So his mother told, Beta, I'll tell you, nobody knows this. I have never told you this. Today I'll tell you. About 20 years before, there were riots like that. And in our locality, all the Muslims were slaughtered. And you were a small baby that time in a cradle. So I lifted you. And they thought, that is my baby. And therefore they didn't do harm. And as the time passed, you were brought up under this Hindu culture. So, by birth, you are a Muslim. But by the culture, you are a Hindu. Now go and kill. This is what exactly happened. We have some wrong notions. I am intelligent, I am not intelligent. I am lucky, I am not lucky. There was one boy, a Gujarati boy, in Matanjari, near Ernakulam. I was in their house for breakfast. He also sat. Then I asked him, hey Gujju, what is your name? I am not a Gujju.
kachi.
Then I asked him, kachi means underwear. I said, can you tie down your underwear or you require mummy? And what is the meaning of lohana? I don't know. So neither I know what is lohana, nor I know what is kachi, but I am lohana kachi. See friends, this is how the world enters our mind when we give undue importance to this world. The best thing is, everything is fine, okay, never mind. Keep the world out. So, samvedanam anantaya prapashyati yadaita sadvasti iti vimoyati vasana vega vaivasya sarupam prajahati sa. And because of this strong impact of this swabhava, the acquired nature, he forgets his essential nature. See, there was one American friend of mine, he met me there in California. He says, Swamiji, I had been to India, most wonderful country. But one problem, what is that? I did not see a single Indian. I said, how come? There were Tamilians, there were Bengali, there were Maharashtrians, there were Punjabis, no Indians. See friends, this is how the samsara begins. Therefore, vasana vega vaivasya sarupam prajahati. If we all accept that we are basically Indian, then anything else, all differences will disappear. Now what is happening? We are giving importance to the differences and forgetting the common denominator. Yat avastuni vastutvam tat chittam viddhi raghava. Therefore, when objectivity is taken as real, that is called as mind. Whenever you think, just observe, whatever you have given importance to, about that only the thoughts come. And thereafter, that what is imagined by our mind, that becomes real. Like Arjun, he became so miserable because of this only. Katam Bhishma Maham Sankhe Dronam Cha Madhusudana. How can I kill Dronacharya, Bhishmacharya? They are worthy of worship, not killing. So he was unable to drop that he is somebody's grandson and somebody's disciple. Actually what he was? A warrior on the battlefield. This is the problem for every one of us. Thereafter, drudabhyasa padarthaika vasana atinchanam chittam sanjayate. And then because of the firm holding on to the objective world, then our whole life is what? If you look within, what we have done? Balastavat krida saktaha, tarunastavat taruni raktaha, ruddastavat chinta saktaha, parame brahmani kupina raktaha. Whole life is spent only in fulfilling our desires. But we have never thought that fulfillment of the desires does not lead to fulfillment in life. What we are actually seeking is fulfillment in life. But because we are giving importance to the objective world, so if we have to write our biography, what we will write? Only two things. I have these possessions and I have these relations. So the objective world is carried by the value that we give in the form of possession, and the relative world, mother, father, brother, sister, they are carried because we are given a status of reality to them. About this I'll tell you one story. I was in Delhi those days, many years before, must be 40, 50 years ago. And there used to be one old couple from Himachal Pradesh. and they were very close to me. So one day I got a message that the lady died. So I called and said, hey, the moment I get time, I'll come. I'll end up somewhere. I'll come later. After 15 days, I have gone. After having gone there, everything we talked, except his wife and her death. Everything. How is the government? How is corruption? See, these topics do not create sin and merit. Because government is an illusion. So, whenever you talk about illusions, it is not real. So, I was talking all the topics. I had nice tea, coffee, samosa, kachori. And when I was leaving, he got up and hugged me. And he said, you are a real Swami. I said, what mistake I have done? He said, you did not make me cry. All the people who came after my wife's death, they'll be talking about her death and make me miserable. And when I cry, then they feel that our visit to this old man is now fulfilled, now he is crying. Then you did not even mention her and you did not make me cry. Why? I said, I'll tell you something, but don't hit me. Okay. Then I told him, how do I know when your wife died, you are happy or miserable? Is it necessary when the wife dies, the husband is miserable? No. I said, I didn't know that. See, friends, don't promote miseries in this world. And this is how the mind becomes stronger and stronger. So, drudabhyasa padarthaki vasanat atichatyaram chittam sanjayate. And this mind thereafter, janma jara marana karanam. Thereafter, old age, death, birth continues. It is the mind which is going through the various experiences, not the body. Somebody asked me, Swamiji, what is the topic you are taking in Chennai? So I said, morning you are taking Atma Bodh. Evening, I said, keep anything. No, please tell the topic. I said, okay. The topic is moral of the story. Now, what is the moral of the story? So I will tell you stories and then the moral you take out. Technically it is called as the Tatparya Nirnaya. Tatparya Nirnaya means the moral of the story. So, here the teacher says, it is the mind that is experiencing good and bad, it is the mind which is born, it is the mind which is dying, but the body, nothing happens to body. And jadana vasyate kinchit heyo padeya rupayar sthiyate sakaram tyaktva tada chittam na jayate. And when be attentive, when we do not give ourselves any choice. Heyo padeya rupataha means something we reject, something we want. I don't like it. I like that. Heyo upadeya. Now here the teacher says, when you give yourself zero choice, then the mind disappears. That is why when we take food, we have this slogan. After the Brahmarpanam, then Aaj ka bhojan bahut accha hai, now eat. Don't give choice. See, my friends, therefore, lesser the choice we give, to that extent our mind is getting dissolved. More the choice, more miserable we are. Lesser the choice, less miserable we are. No choice, we are happy. Like we put only the same clothes. Going to the temple, the same clothes. Going to the funeral, the same clothes. Going to the toilet, the same clothes. no choice, and see your pathetic condition. Whenever you have to go, you stand before those pathetically hanging saris. Because choice. Give yourself minimum choice. To that extent, your mind will not be an issue. Mind is nothing but exercise of the choice. So, as a result, tata antaparityajya shitalashaya vardhineyan vrittistham api tachittam asad rupam udharatam. Such a mind, although is, yet it is not. Be attentive. We perceive the things through the mind. Perception doesn't create samsara. When perception is followed by projection, I like this, I don't like this, samsara means. The wise people live in this world at zero choice level. What should be steady? Asana should be steady or wisdom should be steady? See? Bhagavan says, who is a man of steady wisdom? Well, first thing, prajahati yada kaman sarvan partha manogata. When a person gives himself no choice. Oh, that means he is sleeping all the time. No. Atmanneva atmana tushta. He is at peace with himself. So such a mind is, and yet the mind is not creating samsara or bondage. Therefore, brishta bijo pama yesham vasana rasavarjita achitta itti kathyante jivan mukta ite sita. So their thoughts are like the roasted seeds. Roasted seeds are useful for nutrition. They do not generate next generation. In the same manner, if a Mahatma, throughout his life, suppose he has been in a doctor profession, and then he got into the spiritual path. After he is established in the truth, he will again continue the doctoring. Earlier, he was practicing medicine to cheat others and maintain the patients. Now, he is practicing the medicine, but neither for cheating nor for maintaining. Because he is Jivan Mukta. See? And therefore, such Mahatmas do not want to do anything in this world. Let the thing happen. Don't struggle. I have to do this, I have to do that. No, it will happen automatically. Okay. Then, vasana vashataha pranaspanda tena cha vasana. Now he has a very beautiful thought. Because of the agitation of the bioenergy, the thoughts are born. Because of the thoughts, these bioenergy gets activated. Okay. And thus, each one of them are supporting and the samsara never ends. See? Therefore, vasana vashataha pranaspandam tena cha vasana jayate chitta bijasya tena bijam kura krama. There, as a result, then there is the bija, the seed, and ankura, the result. So this is how the samsara continues. Therefore, what is important is, we have to find out whatever we are doing under whose influence. Is it under the influence of desires or it is under the shelter of wisdom? In Kathopanishad, this thought comes. Every event in our life comes with two options, preyascha, shreyascha. Something we like, therefore we follow. Something we don't like, therefore we reject. Shreya, our attention is it good for my evolution? event is the same. This I had told you in different words. Take every experience of your life as spiritual examination. And when there is examination, you have to be prepared. In a school, the teacher gave the homework. First, she taught 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, 11 plus 11 is equal to 22, 111 plus 111 is equal to 222. Understood? Yes. Homework. Next day, the children came. Everybody has done homework. One child was not raising it. What about you? I have not done. Why? Simple, simple examples you have done. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. And to us you have given 8 plus 9. Where are the fingers? See, friends. Spiritual examination means living at zero choice level. See, my friends, don't give too much of choice. So, jayate chitta bijasya tena bijankura kramaha etasmin suta yokshine kshipram dve api nashyata. Now, between the two, one is the influence of our likes and dislikes, and the second thing is we are agitated all the time because we want something or the other. So, between these two, if one we can conquer, both will disappear. So what is to be done? This technique. Write on a nice paper and fix it on your sink mirror. We live here at zero complaint level. No complaint. Mind will remain at peace. But all our life is only for fulfilling the desires. Now, the teacher continued the thought. Samvedyam etayoho bijam tatyagat nashati dvayam. Samvidam vidhi samvedya bijam ramataya vina na sambhavati samvedya tayalahinam tilo yata. So, samvedyam etayoho bijam. Objectivity is the cause of agitations in the mind and influence of the desires. Objectivity. You know, there are three stages. Janati, Ichchati, and Karoti. This is the technique followed by these TV advertisements. There was one young couple, only two of them, Amdo Amara Bohini, and husband has gone to the work, and this lady useless, good for nothing, watching the TV. And then she saw one advertisement. Potato cutting machine. All pieces will be exactly the same. In 5 minutes, 5 kilograms of potato will be cut. MRP 21,000. If you order now on phone, it will be 2,100. What a good deal. Immediately ordered, and next day the machine came. Now, who are there at home? Only two of them. Now, what will do they with this 5 kilograms of potato cutting? But they have to show it to the world. So they will find out some excuse. See? We have got Ganesh Puja, therefore let everybody come and we'll have the dinner. And after that, so much of potato is cut and sabji is made and everybody is enjoying. Now this lady goes and says, how do you like potato vegetable? Oh, it's very good, very nice, nice taste. Nobody is telling, it is exactly the same shape. Finally, she is frustrated. But don't you observe? All of them are exactly the same shape and size. Do you know? I ordered it. When she did not know about that machine, she did not desire. When she did not desire, she did not order. So three steps. First, janati, we know something. Then we desire, icchati. And then karoti, we order. This is how the samsara is born. Hey friends. Therefore, samvedyam etayoho bijam tatyagat nashyati dvayam. When objectivity is dropped from the mind, then both likes and dislikes and the agitations of the mind will disappear. Then samvidam vidhi samvedya bijam. Therefore, this objectivity is the seed of the whole samsara. See, friends. We have to drop the objectivity. Then the next thought. Samvedanam anantaya dukkhaya jananatmane. Objectivity leads to the infinite miseries in life. Observe and learn from your experiences. When we did not know something, we never get disturbed because of that. The moment we know something, we start desiring. Therefore, here the teacher says, objectivity is anantaya dukkhaya jananatmane. All the miseries are born. All the miseries are born. When desires are not fulfilled, it leads to anger. When desires are fulfilled, it leads to greed. Both anger and greed, they destroy our balance. Anger, we know, no example is required. Now, greed. There was one boy from Rajasthan, and when he got married, his friends told him, hey, you are getting married from day one onward. Don't talk her loving, scold her. Get me that, otherwise. So he took the advice of his friends. And for everything, give me food, otherwise, so she will shake. Oh, wait, I'm giving you. Get my shoes, otherwise, okay, I'm getting the shoes. Continued for 6 months. So he started expecting that to happen again and again. Greed. Then one day she was washing some utensils, her hands were dirty, and this fellow came and shouted, give me hot water to take bath, otherwise. So she was so fed up with otherwise. She said, otherwise what? I will take cold water bath. Life becomes very simple. Bhagavan says in second chapter, Dhyayato Vishayan Pumsaha Sangaste Shupajayate Sangat Sanjayate Kamaha Kamat Krodho Vijayate Krodhat Bhavati Sammoha Sammohat Smriti Vibhramaha Smriti Bhramshat Buddhi Nashaha Buddhi Nashat Pranashat. All our wisdom is destroyed. Therefore, Samvedyam Edayo Bijam Tatyagat Nashati Dvayam Samvidam Samvedanam Anantaya Dukkhaya Janatmane Asamvitti Ajadakya Ajadastha Sukhaya Jananatmane. Asamvitti means now there is no objectivity in your knowledge. To understand this, observe one thing. Any thought begins from the seed called somebody. For nobody, there is no thought. In deep sleep, we are nobody. No thoughts. It is because of this we are told. When you are out of your sleep, before you become anybody, finish your spiritual practice. finish your morning ABCD, yoga abhyas, finish that, then japa, and then chanting the Lord's name, study of the scriptures, meditation, all this we must complete before we become anybody. Suppose we get up in the morning and instead of sitting for meditation as nobody, you sit there as a husband. Then what will be the Ishta Devata or Anishta Devata? The wife will come to stand in meditation. Uto, uto. She friends. Therefore, don't become anybody. So, samvitti ajada yastaha sukhaya jananatmane. Don't give importance to anything objective. Objectivity is given importance in terms of inquiry. Who is that? Where from they have come? How it is? Is it expensive? It is cheap? No need. Don't gather information. Therefore, Sri Rama Vacha, Bhagavan Ram says, Asamvitti ajatyastha kidrushi bhavati prabho. Asamvitto tu jatyam tat. Katham va vinivartade. O teacher, kindly tell, asamvitti, the absence of objectivity, ajadastha is not inert, kidrushi bhavati, what it is like. So, objectivity is dropped and you are no more dull. We all have only this experience. When we drop something, we end up in absence. So, how this, please tell. Vasistha says, Ya sarvatra anavasthastaha vicharantastaha nakutra chit jivona vindate kinchit asamvit ajado hi saha jivan mukta savidheya kurvan karya shatanyapi. Let me attend you. Yaha sarvatra anavasthastaha vicharantastaha nakutra chit. He who is dynamically engaged in this world, he is no more leading a dull-witted life, and yet, jivona vindate kinchit. But he doesn't become the knower, and the world doesn't become the known, and therefore, that experience is asamvit ajado visa. The wise people also live in this world, we also live. What is the difference between the two? Wise people are dynamically engaged in this world, and we know what is their attainment. And we are also dynamically engaged in this world, but under the influence of the desires. One young boy asked me this question, Swamiji, because of Gita, our country is not progressing. I said, very good. Then he said, you say that karmanye vadhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. Do your job and don't expect anything. So, do the job and don't take the salary. This is not the meaning. See? Then I told him, we all are living under the influence of desires. I want this, I want this, I want this, I want this. And we know what we have attained, achieved in our life. We know that. Now take the lives of the great masters. They are not functioning under the influence of any desire. And see their attainment. Attainment is not because of the desires. Attainment is when you are inspired. See, Swami Vivekananda published work in such a small age. It's so much that even if you want to read, our lifetime will not be enough. And what we have done throughout life, only fulfilling desire. What we have achieved, frustration. Therefore, here the teacher says, the wise man, he is functioning in this world dynamically, but asamvit ajado visaha, but he is not leading a life total withdrawal from the world. No. He is very much in this world. And ajadaha. And he So such a jivan mukta vidneya kurvan karya shatanapi. So although he is engaged in so many activities in life, yet he is no more bound by any activity. Whenever we do something, where is our attention? This is a matter of inquiry. Like, I am talking to you. Now, where is my attention? There are three possibilities. Either my attention is on you, whether you will learn and change. The second thing is, my attention is on me. I am teaching the people, ignorant people, I am the wise. And the third, what is the quality of my mind before doing a job, during the execution of the job, after the job is done? Out of these three options, where is our attention? The first option, our attention is on the world. One boy asked me this question. Swamiji, you have been talking Gita, Upanishad for so many years, but people don't change. Don't you feel frustrated? I said, why should I feel frustrated? On the contrary, I don't want them to change. Because if they change, where will I go? Continue, maintain your ignorance. Continue your suffering. All the doctors have got this prayer only. Sarve bhavantu roginah. Not sarve bhavantu sukhinah. In the same manner, our prayer is sarve bhavantu ajnaninah. When God could not change us, will we be able to change the world? And we, because of this, people do the thing and they are frustrated in life. For example, I tell you, this happened in Calcutta many years before. That time I was pretty young. And I was staying with my host, and the same house another person was staying. That another person was old, was 70, 75. And when we met on the breakfast dining table, so he asked me, beta, tum kya karte ho? What do you do? I said, I talk on Gita. Do you think your talk is going to change the world? I said, no. Then why? I said, who will give me food? Papi pet ke liye. Only to get food I talk. If I have got that siddhi, that I can live without eating and without drinking, I'll stop talking. Oh, you are very peculiar. You don't want to change the world? I said, no. Who am I there to change the world? Bhagavan says, Uddhare dharpanatmanam natmanam avasadet. You change, not the world. Our approach is like what? We have a driving license. And from the front, suddenly, a battalion of buffaloes come. And you get angry. Why these buffaloes are coming? You ask them. Now the question is, you have a driving license, or the buffalo there. When we are walking spiritual path, we must change. Not the world. Now, second thing, when we do something, our attention is on us. I am so great. I have done this, I have done that. Now, such people, they do everything, but they have the stink of arrogance, which Arjun had. And therefore, Arjun said to Bhagavan Krishna, that, Kairmaya saha yodhavyam asmin rata samudyame. Let me check who dare fight with me. His arrogance. And then, the bitterness. Dhartharashtrasya durbuddhe. Dhritarashtra's children, they are durbuddhi, they are very bad. With this attitude, when we lead, we are samsari. See, friends. Therefore, attention will be on the world, we will be frustrated. Attention will be on ourselves, we will be super frustrated. But if attention is on our mind, yoginaha karma kurvanti sangam tyaktva atma shuddhaya. keep attention on the quality of the mind, then alone we are walking the spiritual path. So, samastha vasana tyaktva nirvikalpa samadhitaha anandhitvam bhavetacham tat api antarliyate. When samastha vasanam tyaktva, meaning when we have come to a point of zero desire experience, that is the height of bliss. And this bliss also disappears. Means what? Thereafter, joy and sorrows make no difference. Gain and achievement makes no difference. Friends and enemies makes no difference. See? And to know this, one basic principle if we learn. And the principle is, everything in this world is in pairs. There is nothing in this world singular. Joy, sorrows, health, disease, friend, enemy, gain, loss, good, bad, late, on time, clean, dirty. Everything is in pairs. If this is how the world is made up of, what will be the wisdom? Accept the world as it is. But we want the world should be only good. Not possible. There should be only success in life, not possible. There should be only health, not possible. See, friends, therefore, here, samastha vasanam tyaktva nirvikalpa samadhitaha anandhitvam bhavetcha yat tat api antarviniyate. Therefore, how to get rid of these impressions on the mind? Nirvikalpa samadhina, to be attentive. Nirvikalpa samadhi is practiced by the yogis by holding the breath and suspending the thinking process by force. Prana bandhanat liyate manah. But the moment this curfew of pranayam is over, the mind comes with vengeance. Therefore, here the teacher tells that nirvikalpa samadhi taha. What is nirvikalpa samadhi? Be attentive. We have everything in this world optional. Good, bad, vikalpa. Long, short, vikalpa. Near, far away, vikalpa. Options. Is not vikalpa. Now look within. Do we have this vikalpa that I am not? Nobody can have that option, whether I am or I am not. When I am not, vikalpa is not there, then is it wise to say I am? Therefore, nirvikalpa samadhi means abiding in the non-dual absolute self. So, nirvikalpa samadhitaha anandhitvam bhavetchasya tatapi antarliyate ajado galitanandaha tyakta savvedanaha sukhi. So, ajado, not the dull-witted, but consciously living fully, and galitananda, he is not seeking happiness. Very important thing. Don't seek happiness in this world. Express happiness. There are three channels through which we express life. One is action, second is words, third is thoughts. When you do any action happily, your action is fulfilled. But what we do? If I do this thing, then I will get that thing. After I get that thing, then I will be happy. So what we are doing unknowingly, we are postponing our happiness in the future period of time. So when we ourselves postpone our happiness in the future period of time, who can make us happy? Therefore, actions are not done to seek or get happiness. Actions are done to express happiness. Now go deeper. We do not have a choice but to live in the present. All the actions are done in the present. And if actions are done to express happiness, you will be always happy. Therefore, ajado ganitanandaha, don't seek happiness. Then, we express through the speech. So when we express through the speech, Bhagavan says, anudvega karam vakyam satyam priya hitam chayat. Talk in such a manner that it does not hurt somebody's feelings. Then only we are walking the spiritual path. And the third one is thoughts. If we think happily, we cannot be destructive. A miserable person, when he thinks only in terms of destroying others. See, friends. Therefore, ajadaha galitanandaha tyakta samvedanaha sukhi. He has given up all the objectivity fully, therefore, sukhi, he is at peace. Taret dukham mudehe param apara gunasagaram. Now such a master, he goes beyond all the miseries of life and apara gunasagaram. Then there is no limit to his blissful existence. Asthasya samvido rama sanmatram bijam ucchate dve rupe tatra sattaya nana chaikamiti smrute. Now we go to the next step. This samvid or this objective world, athasyaha samvidaha rama sanmatram bija ucchate. He attends a very subtle thought. Everything in this world is known only as existing. Even the absence is known as existing. See? You are very conspicuous by your absence. There is nobody. So, this world is born out of this pure existence. So, athasyaha samvidaha rama sanmatra bijam ucchate. Now, second thing. Dve rupe tatra sattayaha nana chaikamiti smrute. Now the existence is of two types. See? One type is, it is a multiple existence. And second thing is singular existence. Now continuing further. Ghatata, patata, tatta, tvatta, matteti kathyate, satta rupa vibhagena, yatyat nana kruti smrutam. This is a mic, ease. Existence. This is a camera, existence. This is another my existence. This is a book, existence. So many of them. But all of them are only existence. See? North is space, south is space, east is space, west is space. Think, the son is man, the husband is man, the father is man. So, the one, because of the objectivity, appears to have become many. Therefore, ghatata, patata, tatta, tvatta, matteti kathyate. So, this is a pot, this is a cloth, etc., etc. Satta rupa vibhagena. Then we have as if divided the existence. Yattat nana kruti smrutam. This is called as multiple existence. Now, this multiple existence is reduced to the absolute existence. How? Vishesham samparityajya sanmatram yat alepakam ekarupam maharupam sattaya tat padam viduhu. Now be attentive. The man is the son, the man is the husband, the man is the father. So in this, one man appears to have become many, but essentially he is one. And be attentive. This one is none other than us. See, for example, this is mic number one, this is mic number two. Why they are two? Because in between there is absence of the mic. So the presence of the mic is known as existence, then the absence of the mic is known as existence, then again the presence of the mic is known as existence. Now be attentive. When these two specific existences, mic number one, specific existence, mic number two, specific existence, but in between I is a non-specific existence. Man is non-specific. Son, husband, father is specific. Space is non-specific. North, east, west, south is specific. Therefore, we have been telling again and again, spiritual evolution does not mean we become extraordinary, we become very special. No, we have to drop all specialities. Then alone we are back to our essential self. And this is what is called as the God realization according to Bhagavan Sri Krishna. What Bhagavan says? Jitatmanah prashantasya paramatma samahitaha shitoshna sukadukheshu tatha manapamanayo. Paramatma samahitaha. He has attained oneness with the Paramatma. Who? Only two conditions. Shita ushna sukadukheshu jitatmanah. When the world of complementary opposites comes and dashes against us, his mind remains undisturbed. 50% realize. Then, manapamanayo prashantasya. Honor and dishonor doesn't make any difference. Meaning, one has reached the absolute existence. And therefore, spiritual life is not becoming some extraordinary. Remain ordinary. We don't have to prove anything to anybody. We don't have to justify anything to anybody. Be yourself. Whenever we try to prove something, we have to tell 100 lies. And when we try to justify something, we have to cook stories. See? On the contrary, don't justify. You are not yourself. Over. But we keep on creating, because never there was a time I was ever late. Oh. This I learned from one of great Mahatma who has got tremendous impact on my life. He told me. When I was with him, and then I said, Maharaji, I have to leave this evening because tomorrow my lectures are starting in such and such place. He said, don't go. Cancel your own sankalpa. So my mouth became immediately understood. No, I'm just telling you, go. Try this. Take your sankalpa and consciously break it. And watch the mind. See, because we have become special. No speciality. remain simple. Paramatma is so simple that you call him anything, it doesn't matter. When Yashoda Maya called Bhagavan Krishna, he took the soil in his mouth, she became angry. Were you a pig or what? He did not become angry. He was worried. Oh, she knew that I was the Varahavatar. And therefore, he created an illusion by opening his mouth. And she said, no, it's okay. But if somebody says something to us, how miserable we become. Therefore, Vishesha Samparityajya Sanmatram Yad Alepakam. In fact, existence is untouched by any content. Alepakam. Not contaminated. Now observe this within yourself. Childhood has come and gone. What it meant to us? Nothing. Teenagers come and gone. We are the same. Alepakam. Middle ages come and gone. We are the same. Nothing disturbs us. Old age, body will also go. Nothing will happen. Dehi no spin yatha dehe kaumaram yauvanam jara tatha dehantara prapti dhirastatra vayati. Therefore, sanvatra, only existence, sanvatra samanya matrasya yakoti paramavadi. This is the ultimate. And saivasya jagato vijam yata tasyahi jayate. So the absolute existence is the cause of this world, meaning the world is nothing but pure existence. But because of the conditioning, it appears to be many. Like, what is the cause of oceans, rivers, clouds, icebergs? Cause is water. In the same manner, the one water alone is superimposed with conditioning and we call it different names. Exactly the same way, one absolute existence with the conditioning of names and forms, we call it as Jagat, world. With the conditioning of Panchakoshas, we call it Jiva. With the conditioning of the Maya, we call him Ishvara. And he is one and the same. In this manner, the real spiritual practice is, we don't have to become some extraordinary. Drop all that extra. We don't have to prove anything to anybody. Janan apihi medhavi jadaval lokam acharin. Live in this world as if you are a dumb. You don't have to prove anything to anybody. You don't know this, no, I don't know. Oh, life becomes easy. We stop reacting and we start remaining with our own being. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya